Hello, this I'm Maarten Boerlijst, and we're going to present about Amsterdam University College. I'm head of studies at the college. And
I'm Siem Teusink, and I'm a recent graduate from AEC.
Yeah, and so we will start with some general information, and then Siem will add to that from his own perspective and tell a little bit about what you can do after you completed the program, because he actually did that a year ago.
Yeah.
Okay, first of all, Amsterdam University College is a collaboration of the two Amsterdam universities, the Free University and the University of Amsterdam, and it was founded 10 years ago. And the idea was to offer something extra for students that were capable of doing something extra and students that were interested in doing something extra. And so a couple of years ago, we got our own building at the Science Park Amsterdam, and also the residences, because AUC is a residential college, so that means that all students for the full 3 years of the bachelor live at the campus. Furthermore, it's an honors program, so that means that we select our students, and also we demand a little bit extra compared to normal programs. And finally, it's a very student-centered approach, which means that students can more or less compile their own program. So that means that it's not that we have a laid out program which they have to follow, but instead they can mix and match from a large variety of courses and make their own curriculum. Other things that are special for the college is that we tend to teach from a wider context. So in many programs, in the first year or the first 2 years, you learn only the basics, and then later on you can look at applications. We more or less do it the other way around. So already in the first semester at the college, we're addressing big questions, so big contemporary challenges for the world, like how to deal with global warming and questions like that, or how to feed the planet. And from that, it follows what kind of skills and expertise and knowledge you need for that. And our students tell it that it's a nicer way of learning instead of only learning the basics. I don't know how that was for you, Siem.
For me, it was similar. It's nice to have some kind of view of this is the kind of problems that we're tackling, and now you'll learn these skills or learn the more in-depth content to tackle those problems. Yeah.
Yeah.
Worked quite well for me.
And so we're a liberal arts and science college, so that means that we believe in to educate students that have a wider perspective, so that are not just experts in one field, but instead they can combine fields, and furthermore they can also work together with experts from other fields. And there is a lot of training on this going on in the program. And one of the reasons why we believe this is an important thing to educate students is that the world is changing rapidly, and these classical fields, well, they're still needed, but we also need people that have new skills and that are able to work in interdisciplinary fields. And so we very strongly believe that it's important to educate independent critical thinkers. And a lot of emphasis in the program is on this critical thinking. And so we tend to go beyond the what and the why questions and go more in the mechanistic approach in how things really work.
Yeah.
The college consists of 900 students, so that's roughly 300 students per cohort, per study year. And they all, as said, they all live on the campus.
Yeah.
So it's also the size of the college is confined by the number of rooms that we have available. It's very international, so more than 50%, and actually currently it's more than 60-70% are from abroad.
Yeah.
And we have many nationalities, and we really I think that really adds to the classroom dynamics. It's really nice.
It's an integral part, I think, of the program is to have this mix of backgrounds.
Yeah.
And makes a lot of discussions also a lot more interesting, especially.
Yeah. 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 Being an honors college and being selective kind of automatically makes that our students are very successful in the program also.
Yes.
So most students that come here finish their studies in 3 years, which is the max or the minimal time that you need for the program. We're very happy with that because
can imagine.
And if students fail a course or they run into some physical trouble or whatever, there are all kinds of support systems. But I will tell a little bit about that later on. And finally, we really want to be inclusive. So if the money for the college would be a problem, then there is a possibility to apply for scholarship. Information on that can be found on the website. And furthermore, also if you have special needs like dyslexia or any kind of learning disability, then also we have many possibilities to cater for that. And please do not feel that you would not be welcome at the college, because we really want you to be there and to make it possible. So what can we offer you if you would decide to come to us? Well, first of all, a strong community. And I think this is really special because of the residential aspect.
Yeah.
So you more or less live your study. It's not 24 hours a day.
Almost.
But
yeah.
So you live together on the campus. There's this mix of international and Dutch students. And also, and that comes with the second, let me put them on all. That comes with the small scale, because classes are a small size, so never larger than 25. You also have a lot of direct interactions with the academic staff, and that really makes a difference.
Yeah, that really adds a lot to the experience. If you have questions with a specific project, you can come to a professor, just walk straight in, especially if they're core staff. Yeah, that does really add a lot.
Yeah. And so I also taught at programs where I was teaching for 300 students at a time. And that is really different dynamics.
Yeah.
It's also fun to teach, but there's not this interaction going on. So we're strong in interdisciplinarity. So we do not only think that students should be able to mix different disciplines, but we furthermore want them to be able to integrate and to combine knowledge from different fields on a problem or a topic. And so we also strongly believe in this more holistic approach. As said, we're small scale and intensive. That also implies that every student has a personal tutor throughout the whole program, typically from the field of interest.
Yeah.
And so this tutor helps you in academic matters, but also guides you through the programs and is kind of the first contact if you have any questions about your planning, your future, or how things are going, and so on and so forth.
Are you a tutor yourself?
I'm not a tutor, but I would love to try this in a year.
Okay.
Cool. Yeah. So how was your experience with your tutor?
Well, for me, it was fine. I didn't have that much contact with him because I didn't have as many questions. Generally, when there was a period of choosing courses or you'd have to make a big decision for how your curriculum would look, then I would have a meeting with him and talk it through and give me advice, and that went all quite well. But some of my peers did need their tutor more because they have more specific cases or problems that they need help with.
And what we also see happening is that particularly in the later years, you have lecturers in courses, and sometimes you find a course where you really think this is what I want, and then the lecturer from this course kind of takes part of the tutoring or becomes your contact for the world, for the next step, so to speak. And so the final point here is experiential learning, which we think is very important. It comes a little bit with this idea of learning things in context, but it also comes with taking students outside of the classroom and putting them in a real situation. And a very strong example of this is a course that we have on the Peace Building, which first teaches for 1.5 weeks some of the theories, but then takes the students to Kosovo, and next year also a group will go to Rwanda and see how it really works.
Yeah.
And this really helps. And so, for instance, in the sciences, where you are from, also we have a lot of labs. Where you, for instance, go to the academic hospital and see how things work in practice.
Yes.
And finally, students are very active in all kinds of committees, clubs, and student initiatives. But Siem will tell you a bit more in a moment. So kind of summing up a little bit, it's really about you. So you are in charge of your program. You can more or less assemble your own program, although we do offer some core skills like writing, like presenting, speaking in public. Also, we have, for instance, have a course in logic, which are going to follow, and so there are more parts of the program that you have to follow. But apart from that, there is a large freedom of space of assembling your own curriculum. It is challenging, yes. But it's also very rewarding at the
yes.
same time.
Yes, I agree.
And so we really want to, the slogan at one time was the leaders of the future.
Right.
But that's a bit ambitious maybe, but we really want to educate people that have a broad mind and a broad background, and also that are able, that are not just specialists in their field, but are able to communicate.
Yeah.
So, some detail about our curriculum. This is the build up of our so I already told you there is something some courses that you have to follow. So for instance, we ask you to learn a new language or
yes.
a language that you do not have a lot of capabilities in yet. There are methods courses. Like for instance in science there's a calculus course which you have
yeah.
to follow.
In your algebra.
There are statistics courses for social science, and there's a logic course, there's a global identity course, writing courses, and also there's a possibility of doing internships or community projects.
Yes.
Then a large part of your courses will be in your major. That's a little bit classical in the sense that it's divided in sciences, social science, and humanities. But we see actually that we now have directions which are in between, like in health or like in information science or cognition, or like in environmental sciences. So we see the fading of these classical distinctions.
Which is a good thing, maybe.
Which is a good thing. Which kind of, yeah. And it's also a reason for us to exist, to allow this. There are electives. So there's more than half a year possibility of taking courses all over the place. And finally, you write a bachelor bachelor research project, which we call a capstone, which comes with this figure, more or less. So it's the top stone of your building, where you do your own research and you write about it. So you do the full cycle of research. And then finally, you get your diploma.
Yes.
And so this slide is to show you that we're the largest liberal arts and science college in the Netherlands. And with this size, we're still small scale, but we can offer a lot of different courses within our program. So this is just to show you different directions that you can take. But actually, you're not going to take, typically not going to take a direction, but you're going to mix some of the directions. But we have a lot available.
Yeah.
And furthermore, of course, we can tap into the resources of the University of Amsterdam and the Free University. And there, the possibility for taking courses is enormous.
Yeah, almost endless.
And if that is not enough, you can also go a half year to one of our partner universities, which are basically all over the world. And there you can find any course that you would like and which is not offered by AUC. Have you gone abroad?
No, I haven't. No,
okay.
I decided to do a board year in the student association.
Oh, okay.
Which is why
yeah,
I stayed.
Which is
in,
also very nice.
But,
and so
maybe in the future.
Roughly one third of our students take this option of going abroad, but they also take courses at the UvA or the VU.
Yeah.
And as said, we have a very strong support system, which comes with the small scale. This is partly academic, so that's the tutor, which we already told something about. There's a senior tutor. There's very strong interactions with the lecturers. There's also a strong peer support system, where typically older year students are available, for instance, for support, there's a well-being team.
Yeah.
And finally, we also have professional help for like mental issues, physical issues, and stuff like that. And of course, we have a procedure of being admitted to the college, which typically has two deadlines, so one in December and one in February. Yeah. If you want to come to our place, I would advise you to be an early bird, so to already submit your application by the 1st of December. On the website, you can find all information on what we require. But I should strongly say that if you do not meet all the standards precisely, please do not feel unwelcome. So please do apply. We have a lot of spaces available, and we're not only looking at these requirements. So we also look on additional information, and we want to be diverse. So we also have what we call wildcards. So that means that if you really do not meet one of the requirements, but there's a reason, for instance, you come from a part of the world, of the world where this is really difficult, then we take that in consideration. So please do apply. Also, if you do not meet these strict requirements. And so on the website, you can also find information about how much it costs and stuff like that. Yeah. And I think then now I should hand over to Siem.
To me.
Yeah.
Okay. So I said before, I'm Siem. I graduated last July of 2019 at AUC. And this is a little bit about me. I'm a physics major, physics and a bit of mathematics as well. So I'm a sciences major, but I've mainly focused on the physics track, as we call it. And the reason why I chose AEC is mainly because I was interested in more than just physics. I was looking into physics programs, into mathematics programs, but I also found biochemistry interesting. So AEC really sparked my interest because I was like, hey, here, this is a program where I can kind of explore first and then pick a direction. So that was something that also goes hand in hand with the interdisciplinarity at AUC. I personally enjoyed it a lot when multiple courses or multiple tracks came together and combined. So that was a big thing for me. And on top of that, the international character of AUC compared to a regular course in physics or mathematics in another university in the Netherlands was a big thing. Big extra thing for me. And when compared to other UCs, I personally enjoyed the atmosphere at AUC a lot. That was also something that convinced me to come to AUC. So first I'll tell you a little bit about housing. Something that's actually quite a big deal is that at AUC, this is of course, as Martin explained, a residential college. So you live and you study roughly in the same area with the same people. And that means that you have a guaranteed room in the east of Amsterdam. For 3 years, and that's a pretty big deal. I notice it now that me and my friends are graduated, and we need to find a room in Amsterdam. It's actually very challenging. So having that room for 3 years is a big bonus. Around 2/3 of the units at AC are shared, so you have a single room with your own kitchen and your own bathroom, and 1/3 are single. Yeah, and 1/3 are shared. That can be either a two-person room, so you share with the two of you, you share a bedroom. A kitchen and a bathroom, or a four-person room.
What did you have?
I actually had a roommate for 3 years.
Yeah.
Because I met my roommate at one of the like introduction days when applying for AC, and I liked him a lot, and we decided to get a room together, and we actually stuck together for 3 years, which is a lot of fun.
Yeah.
So if you meet the right person, then that's no problem. But if you come into a room and you don't like it at all, you can always switch after your first year.
Yeah.
Must that be an issue? So it's a 5-minute walk from the academic building, so you really study and live almost in the same place. Every floor has a common area, either a balcony or a common room that you can kind of dress up with the people from your hallway, and that makes it into a very social, community type of area. There's many events happening in the dorms, such as jam sessions or barbecues or parties or dinners. And that makes it a lot of fun to live there. So that's also why Martha mentioned the 24-hour thing. You're studying at AUC, but you also have this very vibrant community in the dorms, as we call them. So here's a little bit about my activities. And first of all, social life at AUC in general. as I said, it is a very tight-bound community because you have these people living together and studying together. And that means that there's abundance of events and activities. These are partly organized by the Students Association, which is a platform for different committees, such as the Performing Arts Committee that I was part of, but also we have a sports committee, people are writing their own academic journal, we have a sustainability committee, and there's 27 of them. And that means that there's many activities being organized. I think last year there were around 360 events in a year, which is almost an event every day on average. So then there's a lot going on, and I think that adds a lot to the experience at AUC, and you feel very welcomed also because everyone's from all over the world. So there's really not a norm, and people can really do anything they want and being accepted. So that's great. And I myself also joined the Student Association board because I liked it so much, and then started organizing events, which is also great because then you have the opportunity to pick up some soft skills along the way.
Yeah.
that you get from organizing events and meeting with your fellow
students.
Is that
you on the guitar?
Yeah, that's me. Okay. I was in the performing arts committee because I like music a lot, and then have opportunity to play with fellow students in a band and also play on the yearly festival that AUC organizes, which was a lot of fun. Yeah, so very vibrant social life. Here at AUC. Yes. So now here's...
Wow, that looks intimidating.
Here is an example of a curriculum. You don't have to bother about reading everything now and trying to encapsulate everything because I'll break it down step by step. But this is a example of a curriculum. And I'm a science major and I actually focus quite heavily on the sciences, which is something you can do, but you don't necessarily have to do. So let's try to break it down. So in my first year... Yeah. You have to do a lot of mandatory courses, as you already said. There's some academic core courses that you'll have to do, such as your introductory writing course, logic, which every student has to do, and my first big questions course. And then there's you're starting to do some of your introductory major courses. So in my case, that was physics, but also your theme course and your methodology course. In my case, that was calculus because I'm a science student. Your theme course is a course you're doing your first year and your last year, which is a broad interdisciplinary course that tackles a single problem, but then from multiple angles, via multiple fields. Mm-hmm. And that I found that very interesting. And so here's kind of where you laid a foundation. I tried a bit of chemistry because I wanted to see if there was something for me, but decided not really to go through with it and stick to physics. So that was my first year, and you also start with your first language course. So you lay in the foundations, and then in your second and your third year, that's really where you get the freedom. And throughout your career, you're doing courses from the academic core, which again contain the languages. Marta already explained a bit about that. And in your second to last semester, you do advanced research writing to prepare for your bachelor thesis. And this is really the academic skills and knowledge that we expect each and every student to have, the standard. Then my major, as you can see, it's a lot of physics and mathematics. There's a lab in there. Every student needs to do a lab. And for me, that was physics lab, naturally. But I also did some discrete mathematics and algebra, which is not necessary for my major, for physics necessarily, but I did enjoy it a lot. So within your major, you also have freedom to explore. You don't have to stick to a certain track, even though I'm an example of someone that really stick to physics, but within your major, you can really also go anywhere you want. And then you finish it, of course, off with your capstone.
And it also depends a bit on what master plans you have.
Exactly.
Plans after.
Yeah,
so if
yeah.
you want to go to a very disciplinary master, for instance, physics, then
you need to do this.
Then
yeah,
yeah, then you can have a quite disciplinary program, although it will still be very much different from a physics bachelor.
Yeah, it will. Yeah, exactly. So I'll come to that at the end of the presentation about what distincts my program from just a regular physics bachelor.
Maybe another thing to add is that if you would decide to apply, then we ask you to make an example program for your own first 2 years. So then you can find out what kind of courses you can pick and what the restrictions are.
So we'll see what kind of idea you have with AUC and why you think it's a fit for you. So we expect you to already think about it a tiny bit. And then the electives. This is kind of, in my case, kind of telling for how much of a science focus I had, because my electives are mostly in the sciences, and this doesn't have to be the case. Like, electives generally are courses maybe outside of your major, but in my case, I did a lot of extra mathematics and programming and a bit of chemistry. International relations is my requirement outside of my major, is a social science course. So this is just an example. I know many people that have combined sciences with social sciences, humanities with social sciences, and there's a lot of freedom to do so, but this also shows you don't have to combine
We're
everything.
We're very happy and proud that we can cater for these different...
Exactly. So the world is yours, pretty much. And what do you do after AEC? Well, I recently graduated AEC, and here are some of my classmates that recently graduated AEC, just to give you an example of what they're doing now. So probably most of them will go into a master program. As you can see, Charlotte and team, Charlotte went into a pre-master because she wanted to do law, and she did the pre-law track at AEC, which allows her to do this transfer program for Dutch law, because of course, if you do a law course in English and you want to switch to Dutch law, then you need a bit of a transition. So that's what she's doing now. Team also decided to going to master's, so he went actually to Copenhagen to do a master degree in climate change science. So that's what he's currently doing. Tim immediately went into working on his portfolio, is now working as an investment intern at ABN AMRO. He studied economics, so you can also immediately start building on your career. And Egle is more of an activist. She is now co-founder and creative director of the Youth Act Conference. So she's more working on awareness and activism, which is also something you can do, and it's also important. So these are some of my classmates. But so this is a graph that's from a couple of years ago that shows you where students end up, either for their masters or for their internships or jobs after AEC. So around half stays in the Netherlands, half goes abroad, which shows that AEC is quite a good place to use as like a springboard to go abroad if you're interested in doing so. And around half the people that goes abroad goes to the UK. So,
which might change, but we'll see.
Yeah, okay.
We'll see.
Change. Very true. Yeah. And this is where they eventually work. And the difficult thing about presenting this slide generally is that it's difficult to pinpoint an AEC student, because there are many different majors, many different interests. So there's not really a general place that people end up. If there is one, then as you can see, it is research. That means that people go on and do a master's and then a PhD and potentially even more. That's where the biggest group ends up. And then there's this giant other category, which can be anything. But besides that, people end up in commercial sector or in consultancy is also a big part. I know people that went into just regular consultancy and tech consultancy, but there's also financial and business, which Tim of the previous slide has gone to do, a management education. So there's the wide range of options, but these are the kinds of sectors that AEC students
maybe to
really
add
get
to
into.
That, it's early days, so our oldest graduates are only 7 years ago they graduated. So many of them are, for instance, currently doing a PhD, but after that it's still unclear where they will end up. Mm-hmm. So that kind of explains also why the research is so large.
Yeah.
That most of them are people still in their studying phase. And actually we're very happy that it's all over the place, because that's also what we want our students to be able to do, to go in many directions, and that's also what we see happening.
So that was the end of this presentation, and I would wholeheartedly recommend you to, if you're interested and this is the kind of thing that sparks your interest, then please come visit us. The next open day will only be in November, but if you want to get a feel of the building earlier, then we run tours every week on Monday, Wednesday and Friday, and all of that information can be found on the website. So if you're interested in this program, I would definitely recommend to schedule a tour, because it does add a lot. It was also for me a reason to apply to AEC after seeing the building.
And so yesterday we had a dinner with the student body, or many students.
Mm-hmm.
And so one of the things that came out of that is that we have this excellent thing attached to us, and that's scary for many students, so please don't be scared by that. It just means that you're above average and that you want more than from a regular program. And if that's the case, then you're very welcome, and please apply, and we'll just take it from there.
Yes.
Thanks.
Thank you for listening.